Hi, my name is Monika, and in my channel, I'm teaching Polish. And with this video, I would like to start a series focusing on the Polish cases. What is a case when we talk about languages? A case or a grammatical case? So this is a grammatical category that serves one or more functions. With a case, we can see what kind of relationship there is between words. Nouns, pronouns, adjectives, and numerals inflect by cases. Let me show you some examples. Ja jestem tutaj. Ja jestem tutaj. So in this sentence, I am here. Ja, I, is the subject. And this is the nominative case. But then when we take another example, lubisz mnie, lubisz mnie, do you like me? You won't say lubisz ja, do you like I? No. You will change ja to mnie, as in English. I became me. Just to show, here we have the subject. In the next sentence, it's an object. So we are changing the case. And it's good to understand that one case can serve more than one function. And you can, from the context, when reading the whole sentence, understand what kind of function it has. And I will show you just some examples to show you what I mean. For example, the genitive case is here. To są buty mamy. To są buty mamy. So mamy is a word in the genitive case. It means mom's. These are mom's shoes. So genitive case is used, among others, to show who's the owner of something. So the possession, the function of possessiveness. But genitive is also used sometimes to show the object of the sentence. For example, here, szukam mamy. I'm looking for my mom. So again, we have mamy, looking exactly the same way, because this is the same case, but it's a different function. Here, we don't have anything to do with possession. It's simply, I'm looking for my mom, and that's it. Or, to dla mamy. To dla mamy. This is for mom. So, mamy is here, again, in the genitive case, and we use this because of the preposition dla. Dla required this genitive case. So to summarize, one case can serve different functions. In Polish, we have 7 grammatical cases. And now let's have a quick glance at them. Let's see the names and some example. So the first basic case is the nominative case. Nominative case, or in Polish, mianownik. Mianownik. And here is an example. Dobry kot. Dobry kot. It means a good cat. So this is the basic form. And then we have the genitive case, or in Polish, dopełniacz. Dopełniacz. And here is how the good cat would look like in this case. Dobrego kota. Dobrego kota. And then we have the dative case, in Polish, celownik, celownik. And the good cat, in this case, would look as dobremu kotu, dobremu kotu. Accusative case would be the next case, or in Polish, biernik, biernik. And the good cat, in the accusative case, dobrego kota. Dobrego kota. Another case is the instrumental case, or in Polish, narzędnik. Narzędnik. And the good cat in the instrumental case would be dobrym kotem. Dobrym kotem. Then we have the locative case, miejscownik. Miejscownik. And the good cat in the locative case would be dobrym kocie. Dobrym kocie. Vocative case would be the last case, or in Polish, wołacz, wołacz. And the good cat in this case would be dobry kocie. Dobry kocie. So we can see that the good cat in Polish can look differently depending on the case. And if you look closer, there are specific endings for the case. Sometimes even they repeat. So let's say dobry is twice in the nominative and vocative case. Or dobrego is in the genitive and accusative case. And dobrym is in the instrumental and locative. And then looking at the cat, then we have also repetitions. Kota is in the genitive and accusative. And kocie is in the locative and vocative. So there are sometimes repetitions of the endings of the word. So very often we just need to read the whole sentence and from the context understand what is the case. And you could see that sometimes the cat had the same form, although the case was different. And it often happens. It often happens that the word looks exactly the same in different cases. So for example, to jest stół. So stół here is in the nominative case, but in the other example, kupiłam stół. So here stół looks exactly the same, but it's the accusative case. And here it has a different function. So yeah, it's not enough to see a word. You need to see the whole sentence. And from the context, then you know what is the case. Okay, we had a look at the good cat. We noticed that the endings change. And this is what happens usually. We create a different form of the word in a different case. So here's another example. Stół will be in the nominative case. And stole would be the same word in the locative case. So what we can see, first of all, there is this ending that jumped in the locative case, a, stół, stole. But also there are some alternations in this, the word. U became o, w became l. And then how would you know what kind of ending to put and what kind of alternation will happen? Well, it depends on many factors. It depends what kind of case is it, obviously. So a certain case has certain endings that can be attached. But also it depends on the part of speech. So if it's a noun or an adjective, there are different endings for that. It depends what kind of gender the word is. So masculine can have different endings than feminine and neuter. It also depends on the number. So if it's singular and plural, we have different endings for them. And also, for example, in singular, there might be no alternations, but in plural, there are sound alternations. And it also depends on the word stem. Basically, what is the ending of the basic form of the word? Then it might depend what kind of ending in the case you will put. And sometimes also the meaning is important. So, for example, if this is a person, then there is a different ending. And if this is an object, then there is a different ending. All those things often need to be taken into consideration when selecting the correct ending or making some sound alternations. So the thing is to understand what kind of cases we have in Polish and what kind of functions they serve. Very often, one case serves more than one function. Then, how to create the form of the word. So what kind of ending will be there so you can recognize this case and yourself be able to create that. So this would be the introduction to the Polish cases. In the next videos of this series, we will dive in deeper to each case separately. Then you will discover what kind of functions each case has, and then how to create the case, how to recognize that this word is in this case. So, hope that wasn't so scary, and see you in the next video.